Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Well, that was a long 3 minutes. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to Game Time. My name is Jonathan Paula, and once again we are playing Earthbound on the Super Nintendo. Where we last left off, we discovered Mr. Saturn Valley, hidden away in the mountains, which also happens to be right next to this place, Belch's Factory. We made it to the waterfall, said the secret password, and waited a few days in your time, 3 minutes in my time, and now we are inside. We gotta track down this slime ball, and he's our next boss battle, so let's get to it. Is this a dungeon? Because these guys look kind of friendly. All right, they're not friendly. I did get a surprise opening attack and won a battle against a person I haven't even met yet. ESI Caramel sounds like a good thing to have. Oh, shoot! All right, what do we got in this trash can here? Jug around in the trash, found a bunch of shit, and got herpes. Come on, little red balls. Let's rock and roll. The Foppy and his cohorts. 108, 118, he was defeated. John attacks. Wow, these guys are easy. Dude, I can foppy you all day. I'm a master fopper killer. Ooh, they gave off a lot of experience. Considering they're a complete pushover, that's what I like to see. Climbing down the ladder. Oh no, look how many there are! Just got gang raped by the foppies. John tried PSI Money Alpha. Boom! He was defeated. Boom! He was defeated. Boom! He was defeated. Boom! He was defeated. Boom! He took a nap and then was defeated! Six at a time like a motherfucker. Gained 2600? Wow. I need to fight these guys constantly. Come on, let's go. Mr. Saturns, why are you working here like Oompa Loompas? It's hard to make the gross sounds that Master Belch does. I know I can't do it. Mr. Saturns, no problem here. No problem here. I can't. Tired, but doing so good, ding. Ah, so honest smile. I think they're being forced to work here against their will, just like the Oompa Loompas. We've got to save them. Master Belch is the slimiest, however, I heard he's also serving some guy. This guy that I cannot believe.
Genghis, it's you again.
Yes! Foppies, you're back! More EXP was gained. It was tremendous, and the peasants rejoiced. Nothing to do or see here but go in this door, so let's check it out. Hey, look out! It's a bunch of zombies and a couple of trash cans. Hopefully the trash cans are worth our IQ capsule inside. Interessante. Let's go ahead and eat the PSI Caramel. Use for John. John recovered 20 pee-pee. John going around the trash can. Let's see here. There's an IQ capsule inside. Becca takes it. What does the IQ capsule do? It increases your IQ when taken. Alright, fine. Then use it. Jory drank it. Jory's IQ went up by one. Alright, great. Back around the trash can. Well, let's see here. There's a broken laser inside. Becca takes it. And that was the end of that chapter. Let's go back out into Belch's laboratory and see if we can't fight our way to the surface. Let's go. Let's go, pal. Ooh, what's that area down there? I don't know. Just gained the power of Hypnosis Omega, which is pretty sweet. Oh, I actually have to fight one of these little blob guys. All right, that's cool. Slimy little pie. Becca attacks 54 damage to Slimy Little Pie. He's attacking 40 damage to Becca. That's quite a bit. It's a good thing I gave her that picnic lunch a minute ago. Let's bash him some more, and he was defeated. But he did get 40 damage on Becca, so he's not to be trifled with. He is a dangerous opponent. Let's go inside, Ooh, look, a butterfly.
Yes!
Excellent. So let's keep battling here. John and his friends have gained experience. Aw, shoot! What's this? Aren't you the Fly Honey Delivery Boy? What's the password? Doesn't mean I don't trust you. Just say it. Say it now. Someone's so quiet, it's getting extremely dangerous. What is a special fellow? Alright, let's go in the door. How many doors left? Oh, there he is! Ugh, he's ugly. Disgusting. And he looks like Jabba the Hutt. Oh, gross!
Are you John?
I say, Yark, 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 there's a prophecy that a boy will destroy Master Gygus. It makes us all laugh so hard. Master Gygus is scared of Sony. I have to be worse than the greatest evil. I'll take you down big time. Get ready for the worst fight of your life. I feel the pain of true nausea.
Yo, where's Princess Leia in the gold-covered bikini when you need her? All right, Jabba Doo Hutt, let's rock and roll. We have to give him the thing we've come here to give him. It's just that can of... He doesn't have it. All right. PSI Beta. Money Beta. Does Becca have it? Yes. Becca has the jar of fly honey. And then Jory will just shoot him. Burped and blew nauseating breath. Oh, lame. Take Money Beta, you fat piece of slug. Master Belch grabbed the fly honey. Becca attacks. Lost his mind by wolfing down the fly honey. Jory felt sick. I gotta save him. Jory, I can't lose you, boy. Healing. PSI. Freeze. B. Freeze, sucker. Here comes Freeze Beta. 270 damage. His body solidified. Jory's feeling much better. Master Belch was able to move. Everyone shoot him. 62 damage. Lost his mind by wolfing down the fly honey. 29 damage. Becca attacks. Bash, bash, bash. Shoot, bash. I don't understand how they're bashing him. I feel like if they just punched him, your fist would just go right through his gunky exterior. Becca attacks. Wolfing down the fly honey. Yes! Take that, you green slob! John and his friends gained a shitload of experience. Everyone leveled up. Actually, just Jory.
Looks like it was able to fly, Burp, but Master Gygus managed to get the Manny Manny statue in the fourth side. The seal assumed me in worse condition than you living in your own puke. I know something about that. It's a little flag, but. Burp! See you later, Belch. Now, look! A secret cave! I escape it! Zoom, Burp! Dying! Goody, Burp!
Alright, you've been drinking a little bit too much of that slurm, pal. Ease off us, Scotch.
Yo, what's up, Mr. Saturn? You worn down?
Oh, doing burp, barb, stinky pew.
Alright, I don't know what you guys are saying half of the time, but, hey, it's good to be back up top where we were not able to reach before. Go in hot spring, barf, blah, 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 blah. Alright, let's go in. I'm all about it. Hey, look, they fixed the ladder so I can get back down to the valley without going through the, Belch factory again. Drink coffee before go? Say to me, yes.
Whoa. This is some pretty gnarly coffee, man. You travel very far from home, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Michael Bolton, what are you doing here?
Do you remember how long and winding journey began? Something pounded at your door. It was Pokey, the worst person in your neighborhood, who knocked on the door that fateful night.
Michael Bolton, ladies and gentlemen, Michael Bolton.
On your way you have walked, thought and fun, yet you've done this, never lost your courage. You have grown steadily.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Scott Stapp of Creed.
Stronger, though you have experienced the pain of battle many times.
It's amazing how similar their singing voices is, isn't it?
No longer alone in your venture, Becca. Step back, gotta prepare, prayer. Someone's at your side. Jory is with you as well. Though he is timid, he came from a distant land to help you.
John, as you certainly know by now, you are not a regular young man. You have a giant penis and an awesome destiny to fulfill. Man, this is one crazy coffee trip. This is why I don't drink coffee. Now, at Dunkin' Donuts, new artisan coffee with acid trip.
The journey from this point will be long, and it will be more difficult.
All right, Scott Stapp. Exhale, breathe deep.
I'm going to battle evil. Which side do you believe in? Do you have faith? The good is triumphant.
This little intermission interlude here is awfully long,
incredibly pointless. And a lot of fun. One thing you must never lose is courage. Jim Carrey, ladies and gentlemen! If you believe in a goal you're striving for, you will be courageous. There are many difficult times ahead, but you must keep your sense of humor. Work through the tough situations and enjoy yourself. Alrighty then. Thank you, Jim Carrey. No problem! When you finish this cup of coffee, your adventure will begin again. Next, you must pass through a vast desert. Proceed to the big city of Boston.
Let's give a round of applause to Michael Bolton, Scott Stapp, and Jim Carrey. Great to have you guys here.
It was our pleasure!
John.
I wish you luck!
Can we speed this up? I got places to do it, more coffee to drink. Let's move. Come on, let's go. Come here. Come on, let's go. Come on. And that concludes our coffee acid trip, courtesy Mr. Saturn Valley.
All right, great. That was pretty great.
Hot springs rest here. Let's go inside. What is this doing to me? The screen, it's getting wider. I can't see. Long ladder can go to hot springs.
You got in and washed all of the extremely dirty gunk off of your body.
Sweet.
Well, I'll boot that. Alright, let's get out of this hot springs then. Because, I'm pretty sure that's Mr. Saturn's semen.
Oh shit! Oh shit! It's Howard Cosell!
Look out, Milo. It is Howard Cosell. Me, the greatest picture taker instantly ever of all time. I'm a genius. I did say so myself. Also, your instant memory is coming right up. Look at the camera. Say fuzzy pickles. Boom. Shakalaka. What a great photograph. It will always bring back the fondest of memories. Goodbye for now, toodaloo.
Nice to have you drop in yet again, Mr. Howard Cosell.
Whole Smoky Way.
What?
Huh?
What? This ding, 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 ding. All right, let's go inside this cave and see what's up.
Oh, what the fuck is this shit?
Now, it's been like a good 4 or 5 hours of game time in my timeline. Ranboob. Ranboob. It's been a good 4 or 5 hours since we've been to a Your Sanctuary location, so I'm hoping that whatever dungeon we're traversing through now is going to end up at the third sanctuary, because it's been a long time. Been quite a bit. We entered 3 like a dozen videos ago. When are we actually going to get to the next one? Hopefully soon. So I'm tired of waiting and I want the game to progress. I know we have the desert and Foreside coming up in the future. Hopefully we'll end up at one of those two locations pretty soon.
Great, we're outside. Oh, shoot.
So some of the creatures became tame, and some of them were just outright murdered by yours truly. So that's pretty awesome, right? Ooh, look, a butterfly. And another cave. How exciting. Let's go in the cave, see what's up.
Holy shoot!
Look, a present. There's a coin of slumber inside. Meg takes it. What the hell is a coin of slumber? Must be equipped as other. Increases your defense and luck. Oh, really? Well, it looks like it works, so let's use it.
As we press on through the dungeon, what mysteries lie in store for us ahead? And oh, wait. We're here already. The third Your Sanctuary location.
You finally got here. This is the third Your Sanctuary location, but now it's mine. Thank it for me if you're there.
I don't know why this giant glowing star from the heavens speaks Russian, but ew! It's a trillinage spout. Gross. I'm just gonna go out all out on him right here. It's all out right here. Just boom. Spy on the big guy. See what his weakness is. And hopefully his weakness is one of the two attacks I just used. $200 damage to the mobile sprout. He stopped moving. Offense 54, defense 88, vulnerable to PSI fire. Good. We want to keep the fire moving. PSI, what other moves do I have? Shield. Hypnosis. Paralysis. That's pretty intense. I don't think I need a 24 PSI attack there. I don't use any of these ever. I'm a very straightforward attacker. I don't use all my different moves and stuff, because I'm leveled up, but, you know, I don't need to. These guys are weak. PSI assist. Shield. To Jory. PSI. Fire! PK fire! Alright, what are we gonna do? Shoot? Goods? Bomb him! Protected by the shield of light. Let's do a round of bashing. Not work on Jory. And we defeated him with a good old-fashioned bash on the head. Got on his friends, gained 11,000 experience. He wasn't even that difficult. Level 30. Level 26 for Becca. HP went up by 11. Jory is 26 as well. Everybody wins. What a happy afternoon. Let's go outside and grab our third sanctuary location. Ooh. Looks like some weird coconut spewing milk into the heavens. La 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 la. La 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 la. Such soothing music. Let's get in that tub of Mr. Saturn's semen and check it out. John thought he heard his mother from far away. She said, "Be a thoughtful, strong boy. And drink lots of Coca-Cola." Sponsored by Pepsi. John Soundstone recorded the melody of the Milky Well. The Milky Well. Of course. It all makes sense. No, it doesn't make any sense. It's the first I'm hearing about Milky Well. John touched the Soundstone to his forehead and gathered his thoughts. Wow. Check it out. We've completed the Giant Step, the Lilliput Steps, and now the Milky Well. What other Your Sanctuary locations are in store for us ahead? We will have to find out together as our Earthbound LP continues right now. Welcome back. Okay, I'm speeding up this entire section because it's just the boring, you know, victory lap. We have to walk all the way back to Mr. Saturn Valley, stock up, trade some goods, you know, have a good night's sleep, talk to the townsfolk. Oh, thanks for saving us. Our village is blah, blah, blah. Then we have to go all the way back through these caves, go all the way back through this valley, these dungeons, and eventually we can make our way back to Threed, where now that Belch is destroyed, the town has been saved. So let's go back to the surface. Oh, look at this. Threed's not haunted anymore, and the people are here to greet me. Hey, what's going on? I won't forget you. Want to come back to Threed sometime? For you, honey, anything. Thank you for bringing peace and happiness to my vagina, and also to Threed. Peace, love. I really didn't think those kids could have saved the town. Who would have ever imagined it? I'm the kid. You're talking to me, pal. Give me some respect. I won't forget you. Won't you come back? I already talked to you. You. Since the leader of the monsters is gone, the ghosts in the tunnel have disappeared. The buses can get through. Excellent. So the monster leader was Belch, after all that. This is great news. The town of Threed has been restored to its playful and energetic, I don't know, state of arousal, where all the town's members are just walking around, dancing in place with a smile on their face. None of them have to go to work, apparently. This must be a weekday, a weekend. So this is pretty sweet. Let's go on the bus. Do not stand in the street. Read the schedule from the sidewalk. What? What was that? What's this sign say then? John, check the bus schedule. It looks like the next bus will come pretty soon. So where's this bus going? Let's get on it. What's up, bus driver? Finally, the bus can make its full run to Tucson. It's going to cost $6 for the lot of you. You want to go? You betcha, sir. Unfortunately, this ride will have to conclude in the next video, because for me, for now, that does it for this episode of Game Time. In the next video, you will find out why we're going backwards and not forwards. Big hint, we have one more final errand to complete. And then we will move forwards to the deserts and to Foreside and beyond. So as always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.